Namaste, I am Juliet and this is Yin Yoga for Exhaustion. It's ideal if you're feeling really depleted of energy, particularly towards the end of the day or week or month, where you've been really, really busy or having not slept very well. There's just going to be three asanas, three poses that we're going to be doing here. So we're going to keep it really nice and simple, and I hope in some way that you find this restorative and nourishing. So before we get started, make sure that you've got all the right equipment near you. I'm going to be using a chair here, but if you are practicing in your bedroom near a bed, then maybe the bed will do. And I've got a cushion on top of the chair just to soften it a little bit. I've got a couple of blocks here, but some books will do, kind of, as long as they're kind of the same shape. A couple of blankets, I've got my bolster, but some cushions and pillows, just bring as many as you can. It should be able to work just as well. And you don't need to get an eye pillow for later on. You don't need to have an expensive or fancy eye pillow. I'm just using an old top that I'm going to cover my eyes with later on. And as you can see, I've got a candle burning just to encourage that nice nourishing and mood to sort of create a bit of calm, a bit of nice warmth here. Do put a fire on because your temperature will drop, as it always does during the yin practice, because we're going to be remaining still. So do rug up, get cozy, wear some socks, some nice thick socks, big jumper, big thick tracksuit bottoms, whatever you need to keep warm. So let's get started. So we're just going to stay here in a seated position just for a few moments to get into the body. So closing the eyes, starting to engage in a more mindful way of breathing. I'm practicing some shamatha, calm abidance. And noticing what's happening to the body as we breathe. And just focusing on that breath. Noticing where it comes from, where it moves to. And really allow yourself to take residence in your body. Nothing else to do but just watch the breath. Noticing the rise and fall of either the stomach or the chest. And beginning to soften everywhere. So really allow a release of the lower abdomen. Releasing of the pelvic floor. Releasing of the shoulders. Maybe the jaw. Or thinking of anywhere else that you could release from in the body. Absorbing this wonderful, beautiful life force that is the breath, prana, that energy that moves in and out of the body, that enables us to live. And just opening the eyes slightly, you don't have to go too wide with the eyes. We're coming to our first posture. So as you can see, I've taken my two blocks here. I'm placing one standing tall and one a little bit lower. And I'm going to get my bolster, but you can get a couple of cushions here. Place them on there. I'm going to come into a wide knee child's pose, but a supported version. So bringing the end of the bolster in towards the crotch, knees about the mat width apart. And then bringing the body forward and then just resting the head here onto the bolster. Just going to time us here. And then the arms, you can wrap them underneath so you're kind kind of feel like you're hugging something, which is always a quite nice feeling. Or the arms can just be placed either side of the bolster or your cushions. And really allow a releasing of the lower back, feeling supported by the props. You may need to place some padding underneath your seat if this is a little uncomfortable for you. So you can always put as many cushions as you need underneath your seat, in between the seat and your heels, just to lift the seat slightly so it doesn't feel so intense on the knees, or you can place some padding underneath the knee, sort of in between the thigh and the calf, just to add a bit more space there. It's another option for you. Otherwise, just take this time to enjoy that feeling of breathing and being held, and noticing maybe you can feel with one ear down if you've turned your head to one side, you can feel the vibrations of the heartbeat. Or even just the motions of the breath. Feel it exaggerated slightly by listening to those vibrations through the bolster or through the pelvis. Close the eyes or soften the gaze. In yin, we encourage you to track sensations in your body, but hopefully here you're feeling nice and comfortable. And so maybe there are no particularly strong sensations in the body, and that's okay. To allow that lovely feeling of support. And then we're about halfway through now, so if you'd like to turn your head the other way so that you have equal amounts of time your head facing the other way, so that it's more balanced. Any small adjustments you need before you surrender into this shape. And you can use this opportunity to play around with the breath. You can take a big breath to balloon out the back sides of the ribs before then exhaling and emptying, enjoying that feeling of really surrendering into a shape. Or you can just practice not breathing and just allowing the breath to breathe the body and just noticing the differences. Being in tune with that rhythm of the breath. Can you let go anywhere else? In the face, the jaw? The brow?
fingers, the toes.
And when you're ready, slowly, no rush at all, slow as evolution, and just bring the body back up. And move the props. And then help bring your knees back together using your hands so that you don't have to immediately engage in the adductors. And then take whatever rebound position you need to, maybe just allowing the legs to straighten in front of you, just very slowly, just noticing how that feels in the body once you've changed position of the legs. And you can feel the energy flow of chi in the legs, the muscles relaxing after being stressed over on the inner thighs. If you need to move, do just in any way that feels good. Before we come into the next pose, so we're actually going to keep the blocks in a really similar pattern and then place the cushions for your bolster on top. We're going to just turn ourselves around here. I'm going to get the blanket ready and my eye mask that I'm going to use. I'm going to bring the soles of the feet together and I'm going to allow the knees to splay out in kind of a butterfly pose. Also going to grab my blocks here to support my outer thighs. It's a little bit fiddly to begin with, but it's well worth it. Here we go. So my head's nice and supported by the bolster. I'm going to keep nice and warm here. Final touch on the eyes. And when the mind wanders, just come back to that breath. Slight opening in the chest here. But the lower back is fully supported. As are the knees, there's not too much of a pull on the inner thighs. You can always get rid of the blocks or support on the outer thighs if you feel like you'd like a little something more going on in your adductors. It's a lovely open shape, opening up the hips and the chest, the heart space, and befriending whatever comes up for you in this state. Not resisting, but just listening to the body. So you've just got another minute here. Start to remove some of the props, the eye mask, blanket, and then with the hands on the outer knees, bring the knees together. You'll just squeeze in the tummy muscles slightly to bring yourself up. And maybe just want to sit for a moment to just enjoy the rebound feelings from that. Into the final posture. Surprise, surprise. Putting the legs in on something to elevate them. You could elevate the hips here as well. Sorry about the noises. And then actually, I'm going to get a blanket. Why you need more than one blanket. Blanket here so it's nice and soft and warmer. And then maybe a block for my head. Something softer like a pillow. And then again the eye mask. And you can stay in here for as long as you like. In this restful and restorative pose. And as you stay here, I'm just going to read something from David White, the poet. Rest. To rest is to give up on the already exhausted will as the prime motivator of endeavor. With its endless outward need to reward itself through established goals. To rest is to give up on worrying and fretting and the sense that there is something wrong with the world unless we are there to put it right. To rest is to fall back, literally or figuratively, from outer targets and shift the goal not to an inner static bullseye, an imagined state of perfect stillness, but to an inner state of natural exchange. The template of rest is the natural exchange of the body breathing, the autonomic giving and receiving that forms the basis and the measure of life itself. Rested, we are ready for the world, but not held hostage by it. Rested, we care again for the right things and the right people in the right way. In rest, we re-establish the goals that make us more generous, more courageous, more of an imitation, and someone we want to remember, and someone others would want to remember too. I will leave you here. You can stay in this posture for as long as possible, or you can make your way into a shavasana for as long as you need. Thank you for joining me, and enjoy your rest. Namaste.